The Limey is Steven Soderbergh's 1999 film starring Terence Stamp as an ex-con and a father who receives word that his daughter Jenny has recently died suspiciously in America. Wilson is English, hence the title, and he comes to L.A. to investigate her death and also her life, because being a repeat offender has severely limited his relationship with Jenny. We see Jenny in flashbacks as Wilson progresses in his search for clues, and it comes as no surprise, perhaps, that she's hooked up with Terry Valentine, played by Peter Fonda, an older man with some ironic echoes of her father's character. Wilson went to jail for stealing concert receipts, a job that Jenny warned him against. Valentine is, conversely, a music producer, famous for packaging 60s music, but now he uses his shrinking enterprise to launder drug money for some very bad people. Jenny's reaction to that is similar to the one she had to her dad's crimes, and it leads directly to her death. This is a great Dad After Dark movie, for sure. It has good action, car chases, shootouts, hard-nosed Cockney slang, amusing fish-out-of-water moments.
Looks like he's brought in the heavy mob.
You're kidding.
Extra muscle.
Little valets, man.
But if you do like a more layered, textured story, there's a lot going on just under the surface. A lot about fatherhood, fears about providing, of course, and what you're willing to do or become in order to fulfill that role. Becoming a disappointment to those you love and are ultimately making those tough choices for.
She was always so embarrassed. Ashamed.
Not ashamed. Disappointed.
But what I really wanted to talk about is how it's also about how all of us put on personas in order to be what the people around us need us to be sometimes. Everyone in this movie is acting in one way or another. The characters themselves are putting on airs. Even Jenny finds herself the latest in what seems to be a line of younger women that Terry Valentine exploits to make himself feel young, relevant, and powerful. When Wilson tracks him down after Jenny's death, Valentine's already shacked up with another young woman, aspiring to get ahead in her career. There's an interview with Lem Dobbs, the screenwriter, and he says he wanted Wilson to find Jenny's photograph in Valentine's house among a long line of other women that he's known through the years, to make just that point. And in the movie, that photo itself resembles a headshot. It probably was a headshot. And Valentine's life is like a drama that he cast that role for over and over again, transferring his affection onto the next person to take the part. His current girlfriend is named Adhara, and actually translates in the English to the virgins or the maidens, plural, to further cement that role as one in a long line of people to come and go in his life. He even tells her at one point the same story that he's told her before, losing track of which girlfriend in that role that he said it to, trying to make himself more attractive.
But man, I tell you, I think the only reason I'm alive and telling this story now is because of the big FL front end and that solid tire on my fat boy.
You told me this story before.
Did I really?
Yeah, you did.
I'm sorry.
But I'll hear it again if you want.
Oh, you're sweet.
And of course, Valentine reciprocating is acting as a replacement father figure for her, for Wilson, who was in jail all that time. The ending is even a bit on the nose about that, and we understand immediately that Jenny died repeating a line she'd used on her father 100 times.
If you're naughty, Dad, I'll put the law on you. Promise. She didn't want me to get sent down again, see? And if she got wind that I was planning something, I'll shop you, Dad. I promise, I'll shop you. I can see her picking up the phone.
The Limey also stars 60s icon Barry Newman, Valentine's chief fixer, bringing criminals into his life, then bringing in even more criminals on top of that to fix the previous trouble that he created. The film positions itself as a thriller. He brought the original drug deal to Valentine that ultimately brings Wilson to their door and destroys their entire operation. And now Wilson is basically karma, appearing in all these lives to reset the scales. Luis Guzman plays Jenny's friend, the reformed criminal who shows Wilson around and sets him up to get his revenge. But how did he know Jenny?
Jenny was in my acting class.
Lesley Ann Warren was their acting instructor and a type of surrogate mom for Jenny, also now in over her head. She delivers a great line here as we get to know Wilson early on.
You and Terry Valentine at 20 paces? Come on. Is that it?
Don't see why not.
Are you serious?
Have you ever known me not to be?
Oh, you fucking guys and your dicks, man.
And then we have Nikki Catt as hitman Stacy, playing the role to the hilt, diegetically in the film, and also popping out as the action momentarily centers on a film set.
Extras? Excuse me, background artists, right?
Hey. Hey, Mom. Hey, Dad. How's it going? Yeah, Hollywood's great. Yeah, still a loser.
The hitman Stacy does a bit about filmmaking, role-playing, acting, and the ugliness that sometimes comes along with storytelling. And I'm just thinking now that the Limey is also about breaking with all that. Terry Valentine, at the center of all these character types, himself a child of the 60s and the optimism and idealism of all that, has committed the biggest sin possible. He's broken type. He's no longer a 60s idealist. He doesn't think of the 60s as a magical lost time anymore, even though it's what made him what he is. In fact, he minimizes it at one point, denigrates it.
A place that maybe only exists in your imagination. Someplace far away, half remembered when you wake up. When you were there, though, you knew the language. You knew your way around. That was the 60s. It was just 66 and early 67. That's all it was.
And stepping outside like that allows him to see it as just another product to sell. And he went even one step too far, perhaps. He stepped out of his time and into the 80s and 90s zeitgeist and perverted the 60s into a crime story, just another front to sell drugs. And it's no wonder that Terence Stamp, a famous figure in the 60s, follows him. He's almost like a Terminator from another time himself to set things right, to kill Terry Valentine. The movie even becomes very law and ordery at one point, with a little Tarantino-esque monologue thrown in for good measure.
There was this screw what really had it in for me, and that geezer was top of my list. 2 years after I got sprung, I sees him in Holland Park. He's sitting on a bench feeding bloody pigeons. There was no one about. I could have gone up behind him and snapped his f***ing neck. Wallop. But I left it. I could have nobbled him, but I didn't. Because what I thought I wanted wasn't what I wanted. What I thought I was thinking about was something else. I didn't give a toss. It didn't matter, see? This Burke on the bench wasn't worth my time. It meant sod all in the end. Because you've got to make a choice. When to do something and when to let it go. When it matters and when it don't. Bide your time. That's what prison teaches you, if nothing else. Bide your time and everything becomes clear and you can act accordingly.
The thing I don't understand is every motherfucking word you're saying.
But for all that, it's still in the end a simple story of a father who loves his daughter in his own way, within the limitations of his character and with his weaknesses in tow. And the ending reveals to us, as fathers ourselves, perhaps, that it's our own posturing, our own self-image, and the frailties that come with that, that are sometimes the biggest threat or influence on our own children. Our own self-absorption, hoping to be whatever, strong, wise, pithy, funny, or self-righteous, or righteous, in our attempt to instill something of value. And it can backfire. Because our lives feel like a kind of narrative. And this movie revels in that. And in the end, out on the beach, face to face with Terry Valentine, Wilson looks down into a type of funhouse mirror. He sees how his own posturing with Jenny, the little dramatic scene they would share from time to time, was misread ultimately by Valentine.
Tell me about Jenny. Tell me about Jenny.
I needed money. I would have given her anything she wanted, but she didn't want She found out about my deal. She tried to stop me. She said she was gonna turn me in. She said she was gonna call the cops. I couldn't stop it. It already happened. It was over. She was going to call the cops. She meant it. She had the phone in her hand.
And she never would have, we find out. Not on Wilson and not on Valentine. And Wilson realizes it's his fault for not being there, for letting that line replace any connection they might have had had he given up his role in the imaginary thriller story of his life and just been her dad. Maybe a poorer dad, but a present dad. And so he walks away. There's no one here to kill or to get revenge on. It was him. He fated Jenny because he wasn't there for her. As a dad, I think of the Limey sometimes, and I know that sounds odd, but it helps me remember that kids can see us as archetypes as much as, sometimes more than, they see us as individuals, especially early on in life. So what type of narrative is playing out in our homes? Hopefully not a thriller, and hopefully you're not the heavy. Just be a dad, I tell myself, without comparing what that means to other dads, or God forbid, to the archetypes we might have learned growing up. That's what Wilson forgot to do, and that's what we should remember more often. She just needs you. But movies can tempt us that way, to put on these personas that we can never really carry off, ever. But this movie reminds us of that on some level. And it's also a lot of fun. The car chases, the standoffs, the fights. It's just a great movie, so watch it just for that stuff. Guys, thank you for tuning in for Dad After Dark. The Limey was recently reissued in 4K, so check it out if you're up late some night and the kids are in bed. It's not for kids, but it's a lot of fun. One of Soderbergh's best. And if you do watch it, let us know what you think down in the comments. So take care, and we'll see you soon.
I'll be back.
You tell him I'm coming! Tell him I'm fucking coming!